Sometimes when you have completed your article and you're trying to optimize it for the search engines, you may encounter some issues that are complicated to fix. It is frustrating and you may spend a lot of time trying to fix those issues instead of doing something that is more important. What if I tell you can leverage AI to easily fix those issues? From having it optimize your SEO title and description, to adding the focus keyword in the subheadings, optimizing your page title, to making your content short and concise. Almost every SEO optimization issue can now be fixed with AI with a simple click, and I'm going to show you how everything works so you know what to expect. Let's go! Hey, it's Jack from RankMath, the one SEO plugin that empowers millions of WordPress sites, and this channel is all about helping you grow your search traffic. So if you're new to us, subscribe. All right, let me go through with you all the optimization one at a time, starting with the SEO title. Now, the first thing you need to do before you start optimizing anything with AI is to add your main focus keyword, which is the keyword you want this piece of content to rank. Because if you don't add a focus keyword here, how would the AI know what you want to optimize, right? So in this case, the keyword is best electric smokers. And as you can see, it says that the focus keyword does not appear in the SEO title. And that's because if we click on the edit snippet button, I've intentionally done this to show you what you can expect from this Fix with AI feature. So to fix the SEO title, we can click on Fix with AI. Give it a while, and it will bring up the edit snippet pop-up together with the generated SEO title. Now, if you are happy with this SEO title, you can click on approve. But let's say that we want it to give us an alternative. I can click on regenerate. Give it a while, and here we go. Now, if you like the previous output instead of this, you can simply click on this back arrow, and the previous output will be selected. And even if you generate more, the outputs will keep stacking, and you can select whichever output that is most suitable for your content. And once you are done, you can hit approve, and let's check this out. You have passed this test. Optimizing the SEO meta description with AI is the same thing. If you ever fail this SEO check, you just have to click on the Fix with AI button and it will start generating an optimized SEO description for you, as you can see. If you think this meta description is good enough, you can approve it, close this off, and you will see the SEO check is fixed. Simple and easy. Now, normally if your page title contains your main focus keyword and you have saved the article, inherently your URL will have the focus keyword in it. But if you are seeing this issue, then all you have to do is to click Fix with AI, give it a while, and the permalink or URL will be adjusted. Click on approve, close this off, and now the issue is fixed. Now, for SEO optimization, it is important to have the main focus keyword in the first 10% of the content because it gives context to the search engines that the page that they are crawling relates to the main focus keyword. Hence, if you're getting this focus keyword doesn't appear at the beginning of your content's issue, where you can see there isn't any sign of the focus keyword, you can simply click on the Fix with AI button, give it a while, and it has generated a line which includes the focus keyword. The generated content will be highlighted like this. And if you're happy with this, you can click on approve. And even if you click on reject and you change your mind, you can always click undo. And the generated content will be back here. We have passed this SEO check. Simple and easy. Now, generally, when you optimize for the focus keyword in the first 10% of your content, you shouldn't need to optimize for this check because it is inherent. However, if you decide not to have the focus keyword in the first 10% of your content, but you still want to optimize for this to have at least one focus keyword in your content, then just click on Fix with AI, give it a while, and here you go. You have fixed two issues at one go. This is not always the case, but we got lucky here. Now, this is something quite awesome because sometimes you will find it hard to write more on the content you have already written. So if you want content AI to analyze your content and help you write more to make your content more comprehensive, that is if your word count is below 600 words, you can click on the Fix with AI button and it will help analyze and write more content for you. In this example, I'm struggling to write 600 words and I've created an outline of what I want in this article. So let's click on the Fix with AI button. Give it a while, and here we go. It helped us pass this test. And as you can see, all these highlighted texts are written by Content AI. So basically, the AI will help optimize your existing content to its fullest. Up until now, we have covered all the basic SEO fixes, and I really want to know what you think. Will these features help you out? Let us know in the comments down below. Now let's go on to the additional SEO checks. Strategically placing your focus keyword in the subheadings can enhance the clarity of your content, and the key is to add the keyword naturally and contextually. Never overstuff subheadings with keywords because it can lead to awkward phrasing and may negatively impact user experience. So if you have not passed this check, you can have Content AI scan the headings of your page, and here we go, we've passed this check. Let's see if the AI has added the focus keyword naturally to the heading. And here we go, this is quite natural. Now, keyword density is not really important in today's context, and we often recommend to write your content naturally, so most of the time, you will neglect this SEO check. But since we have AI to optimize the keyword density, why not, right? So as you can see in this example, we have added the focus keyword 4 times in this article, which makes up to 0.14% of the content. The recommended keyword density is between 0.5% to 1.5%. So let's have the AI fix it for us. And here we go, we have borderline passed this test. The AI has added 11 more of the focus keywords. Let's see if they make sense. Well, this is somewhat acceptable. Let's scroll down. It says here, however, the best electric smokers often allow you to host big BBQ parties or smoke larger cuts. This sounds good. And then here, the best electric smokers come equipped with digital controls, timers, and even remote monitoring, which sounds good as well. So the AI did a good job. But if you happen to spot any that does not make sense, feel free to remove them. This makes sense, I'm just giving you an example. Check this out, the focus keyword is best electric smokers. And currently, it is at the beginning of the SEO title. And that's why when you check out the SEO test for this, you would have gotten a pass for it. However, if we go to the SEO title again and switch the position of the focus keyword to the end, let's check out the test again. You will see a fail. Let's simply fix this, wait for it, and here we go. The SEO title is fixed. Simple and easy. Positive or negative sentiment and power words are really important for SEO title because the click-through rate of your article depends on it. If your SEO title does not evoke emotions or does not entice people to click on it, then there is really no point in writing the content because no one is reading it. So as a RankMath user, we have these checks for you. And if you want to know what words we are looking for in these checks, you can click on this question mark, which will lead you to this page. Scroll down a little and you will see these two links. Click on this and it will provide you with a list of positive sentiment words. It is a long list. The same goes for the list of negative words, as you can see. And as for the list of power words, you can go to the power word check and click on this. And then click on this link, scroll down a little, and select your content language. And here is the list of power words. Now, back to the page, sometimes it is hard to find a suitable sentiment or power word, and it may take a lot of time. So instead of making the effort to include the recommended words in the SEO title, why not have the AI do it for you? Now, currently, the main focus keyword contains a sentiment and power word, which is best. And just for an example, let's remove that word. And if we check out the SEO test, we have failed them. Now let's start with fixing the sentiment word by clicking on the Fix with AI button. And here you go. It has included a sentiment word. Sometimes you will get lucky if the AI pick a sentiment word which is also a power word. Then in that case, you will pass these two checks. But in this example, we still have to fix the power word. So let's approve this and fix the power word. And here you go. It happens that the AI has selected best as the power word, which is also the sentiment word, as well as the main focus keyword. Anyway, these fixes focus only on adding the power and sentiment words. So if it happens that it doesn't include your focus keyword, make sure that you add it. I've break up the focus keyword earlier on purpose for this example. Having logical numbers in your SEO title, especially if it is a list style content, will help improve the click-through rate, like the top 10 movies to watch during Christmas or 7 tips to boost search traffic. Having a number in the SEO title does make it more enticing to click. So in the SEO title, as you can see, there is no number in it. And well, obviously you can easily add a number here, but you also have the option to have the AI add the number for you when you go to the issue itself and hit Fix with AI. And the AI will scan parts of your content for a number and it will add it to your SEO title. Simple and easy. Over the years, we are accustomed to reading short paragraphs instead of a chunk of text. And if we happen to visit a page with a chunk of text, we will leave almost immediately because it is not optimized for user experience. So with this check, we are looking for any paragraphs that are longer than 120 words. And as you can see, we have one or more paragraphs that fit the criteria. Now, to know which paragraph or paragraphs that are being flagged, we can click on this eye icon, scroll down and look for any highlighted parts. And here we go. This is the paragraph that is longer than 120 words. Now, you can separate the paragraph manually or you can leverage AI to do it for you. And here we go. The issue is fixed. So with a simple click, any of your SEO optimization issues will be fixed. You spend less time on optimization and more time on content creation, which is the most important thing, right? Anyway, if you have any thoughts or suggestions, feel free to let us know in the comments down below. And if you find any of these features helpful, do help us out by smashing that thumbs up. Our channel is all about helping you grow your search traffic. And if you haven't subscribed to us yet, do consider doing so. This is Jack from RankMath. I'll see you in the next video.